I'm the one that can make you girls a star.
Last night's elimination was kind of odd.
Megan, I'm sorry. You will not be in Girlicious.
Megan went home, and I really thought that I was going to be the one going home because I'm very different. When I walk onto a stage, like, they see this tall girl with red hair, and I don't know if it's a plus or a minus. I think it's a little bit of both.
I know I have it. I know I'm getting more comfortable, and I'm not really worried. As long as I work hard, you know?
I understand probably why they eliminated her. Megan probably just doesn't have that it factor, but I do feel Ilisa should have gone home this week. She doesn't really mesh well with the group. I really don't understand why she's still here.
I still feel like I'm still a cream of the crop. Like, I really do.
I'm very competitive because my dad and my uncle, Ron Sayers and Gail Sayers, they were both in the NFL. They've already been in the limelight, so it's now kind of my turn, and I'm going to do it.
I feel like more mature, and I truthfully, this may sound really stuck up, but I don't really give. I feel more educated. I mean, obviously, I am.
I'm 21, and I'm a mature 21. Like, I just went into the kitchen. I had my glass of wine. I like to read my book. I like to chill out before I go to bed, you know?
I am such an overachiever. I go to USC. I'm in the top 15% of my class. I'm pre-dental.
I'm very focused, and like, people are like, she has a different backup plan, and she's smart, and she goes to school.
It's not like because I am smart and I can go to school that I don't want to be here any less than anybody else. I really do want to be here.
Girls, gather around! There's a plaza lesson! Let's go!
Hey, sexy girls! It's Carmi and it's Jessica from the Pussycat Dolls. Charisma is who you are combined with how you show it off. And you can magically turn fans into
fanatics!
Robin's waiting for you in the studio. Good luck.
Go, go, go.
This week's song assignments are the perfect opportunity for you to show me just how charismatic you really are. And when a performer has charisma, you can't take your eyes off them.
I think I'm the most charismatic person in the house. I for damn sure make or break things around here. That's for sure.
Okay, girls, I'm gonna choose three team leaders based on who did the best in the last performance. So, my first leader, Charlie. Carrie. And, well, Kristina. Charlie, you get These Boots Are Made for Walking by Nancy Sinatra. Carrie, your song is Girls Just Wanna Have Fun by Cyndi Lauper.
Okay.
And Kristina, you get Respect by Aretha Franklin. Charlie, pick first girl.
Tiffanie.
Jamie.
Ooh. All right.
First girl I'm gonna choose is Natalie.
Drum roll, please.
Nichole.
I am going to go with Alexis.
Aww, thank you.
Jenna.
Hot.
Carrie, it's your turn.
I'm gonna have to say Cassandra.
Ilisa, we'll end up in Respect.
It was friends go with friends and friends and friends and friends. It kind of felt like, oh my gosh, I'm the last one picked. I'm a very serious person. And in comparison to all the other girls, I'm very mature.
So, it's time to get to work. You ready?
Boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. And one of these days, these boots are gonna walk all over you.
You have such a habit of going exaggerating nothing.
let's not make it unnatural.
Tiffanie has a lot of drama, and you kind of worry if she has a switch to tone it down.
And one of these days, this one's gonna walk all over you. Girls wanna have fun. Girls wanna have.
Wait, what's your verse?
My main focus right now as being team captain is to make sure that all the girls are 100% prepared for this performance. So, you know, I've encouraged Alexis to work harder for it.
I'm just kind of like skipping out, but then get your vocal together and then pull back a little bit. Okay? You got to really express and be hot. And what's going to be sexy is for Alexis to be Alexis.
This style is totally different for me. I was trained classically, so it's hard for me to pick up the funky choreography because I have to let my center go. And for a dancer who's trained in ballet and tap and jazz, it's hard.
Find that sexy in you.
I look up to Aretha Franklin. I really like Aretha Franklin. I like her style, I like her beltiness, and I feel like I have that same type of power.
Chrystina has been taught to sing a lot of songs way beyond her age, and it's got a certain kind of pushing in the voice that I don't like, that's uncomfortable. Try not to have the ghosts of Aretha and everybody else in your head.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, What do you know, you guys? 5, 6, 7, 8, boom, dun dun dun. 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, no, this is the simplest choreography ever. If you can't get it, it's no good.
For me, it was really hard to have Ilisa in my group because we want to blend as a group, we want to mesh as a group. But, you know, and Ilisa, red hair and all, and being all tall, and she just kind of like stands out like a sore thumb. I see that there's talent, but everybody knows that Ilisa's not going to be part of Girlicious. Like, she's just not Girlicious enough.
Ilisa is kind of oddball. I don't think she really fit into Girlicious. In my head, I imagine girls who are girly and just look fresh and new and young.
Where's Jenna? Come on.
Bitches, better wait.
Better hurry up.
I feel so bad for Ilisa. She's always hiding in the corner. She never talks now.
Yeah, she's always kind of like hanging out by herself. Like she doesn't want to hang out with anybody.
I know what she does. She says the weirdest things though.
And yeah, she's like, she makes everybody feel really uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm. Ilisa doesn't really blend well. And we all kind of have like a person we can relate with. For Ilisa, she just kind of like stands out. I try to be nice to her, but I feel like it's uncomfortable. Like the way she like wipes her like face and like then just touches it.
The way she sits, she's all
with a skirt on. She's like, I'm a man. I have a skirt on, but I'm gonna sit like a man.
To me, she's not my competition personally.
5, 6, 7, play. You know that I'm into you. I don't need a man.
I hate this.
Hey, wait, time out a second. I'll help you guys out. Ilisa goes, Ilisa goes. I'll help you guys out.
I already know that the girls think I'm different, and I'm trying to get over this right now, and I'm having a tough time with that. I've been through so much in my life. I have what's called arrhythmia, tachycardia. My heart beats like this, and I faint, and I pass out. And the first time it happened,
my mom was taping me dance on my camera and didn't realize that it was still on.
Oh my God! Oh my God, get a doctor, quick! Get a doctor!
These nurses ran out of nowhere and started giving me CPR.
Please wake her up!
Here we go!
Please, wake her up! Good! Please!
I didn't come back for 30 minutes and was declared dead.
She's not breathing?
I went through a life-changing experience, which gives me a different perspective than most of the girls in the house. It made me realize my purpose is to touch people with my music.
Hey guys, can I talk to you?
I feel like nobody likes me in this house.
and I just want to have people like me for me.
Well, I feel like kind of like you're almost like the oddball. You just like really don't fit in.
I live in this house with you guys. I want to be included as much as I can, and I try so hard. It's like I'm here, but I'm invisible.
I guess I've never known what it felt like to be the oddball. So I don't really know what she's going through.
It's like I can never be perfect for this set of girls, and that's why all my friends are guys.
Yeah. And that really shows. I think you have lack of knowing how to get along with girls because...
Well, I put myself in this situation because girls are catty to me.
She doesn't have people skills, especially with girls. It's kind of obvious why she doesn't really get along with us. I've been around girls. I know how to deal with girls.
Seriously, what do I do?
Don't try too hard. Like, I feel like you're trying too hard sometimes. She's almost forcing the chemistry to happen. You can't force that kind of thing. You just have to be yourself.
These past few days, I'm like down. I'm really down.
So girls, this week has been all about charisma. Now it's time for you girls to see it up close and personal. I'm going to take you to meet one of the most charismatic girls that I think you've ever met in your entire life. Her name is Nichole from the Pussycat Dolls.
What? Are you serious? We were so excited.
I'm going to take you to a listening party, and we're going to hear her debut solo album. And here she is, Nichole Scherzinger.
How are you guys feeling today? Well, thank you so much for coming to my album listening party. So, are you ready to hear some of my songs off of my album? Her name is Nichole.
This song, it's called Just Say Yes, and it came straight from the heart. Hopefully you'll like it.
I want you to stay here.
She opened her mouth and just started singing, and I was just like, it just touched me.
Just say yes, cause I'm making.
The thing about her voice is like, it was just so beautiful and so precise. When I looked at her, I saw my future, and it was just very emotional and very inspirational. And she just made me feel like I'm gonna be like you one day.
Yeah. All right, girls, I'm so excited for you guys. Are you guys happy to be here?
Yeah. Now, as you know, this is a competition, and one piece of advice that I would give to you, lovely ladies, is find and understand charisma. It's that thing, that personality, that sparkle that will separate you from everybody else. You just can't be afraid to be who you are. So girls, good luck.
Thank you again for listening to my music. Kick some butt. Make me proud.
Now it's time for your challenge. You girls are going to be performing a song you all know by the Pussycat Dolls, I Don't Need a Man, right now. There's a catch. I will not be judging you this time.
What?
Instead, you will be facing the toughest critics that you will ever, ever meet. Your fans. This is part of the key demographic you want buying your CDs.
When I first found out that the kids were going to be the ones judging, I was excited because I was like, good, somebody besides Robin is going to be a non-biased opinion about how we perform.
The girl who shows the most charisma will be exempt from this week's elimination. All right, so we'll start with group one right here, and the rest of you girls, go on backstage. We'll see you in a minute.
We get to watch!
We get to watch that.
So we go backstage, and there's all these like chairs lined up for us to sit at and these screens where we can watch, you know, the other girls perform.
All right, everyone, let's give it up for group one.
I see you looking at me like I got something to show you. And the way that you stand on today, cause I'm not about to give it all up to you.
Come on.
There is something I won't do, and I'm not afraid to tell you I don't ever wanna leave you confused.
The more you try, the less I fight, and I don't have to think it through. You know if I'm into you, I don't need a man
to make it happen. I get on being free.
I don't need a man
to make me feel good. I get off to my feet.
so much. Off you go. We'll see you in a minute. All right, girls, I want to hear what you have to say. Let's talk about Nichole. So everyone, this is Nichole.
I think that Nichole was awesome because she was one of the better vocals in the group.
I like her!
We're going to the next girl, and her name is Jamie.
Jamie was actually one of my favorite dancers. I felt that she brought a lot of charisma and a lot of power to her group.
I like these kids.
Okay, we're going to talk about Charlie now.
I think Charlie's dance moves can be better.
I didn't find Charlie memorable. Like, I had to flip to her page to remember her. She didn't really stand up.
Thanks so much.
I thought Carrie, her dancing wasn't as good as her voice.
Oh, God!
Cassandra, I thought her dancing was kind of jerky. Like, you know, like sharp movements, so it didn't really flow very well.
So apparently, I can't dance. Got it.
I was not expecting for them to be so critical and to be so intelligent. They were like worse than Ron Fair. I swear to God, they were worse than Ron Fair.
Jenna, she seemed really bored on stage and I didn't think she was good.
I'm just listening.
I thought that Tiffanie,
I like her.
Sometimes in some parts she was a little bit too late. And yeah, like when they started, she sort of stopped.
Who are you kids?
Wait! I think Tiffanie, she could have, like, did the dance a little bit faster.
I knew there was a reason why I was more nervous in front of these kids than front.
I was completely caught off guard, and I was like, oh, I thought that little girl liked me. I guess she doesn't.
I thought Alexis was not one of the ones that was the most memorable.
I thought Alexis, for vocals and dancing, she didn't really stand out.
I screwed up the dance.
I thought Chrystina should have brought more onto the stage. You could tell she was trying her best, but I thought she could put a little more effort.
Okay, next we are going to talk about Ilisa. All right, girls, next we are going to talk about Ilisa.
I really, really, really liked Ilisa. I think she had a great personality. I liked her style because it's kind of different than the other girls, and she has a lot of attitude and she's sassy.
Yeah.
And I really liked her, like she had a lot of good facial expressions while she's singing and dancing. And I just really liked basically her overall stage presence, and I thought she had a ton of charisma.
Ilisa was definitely my favorite, I think, out of all of them. She, you know, had her own little kind of sassy attitude, and I did not take my eyes off her when she was performing.
To me, Ilisa was my favorite.
Ilisa got a lot of good compliments. Honestly, all these little kids loved that she's unique and that she has something different. And so now I feel like she could be competition.
I liked her style and I liked the way she danced. She was a really good singer to me. She brought it.
Yeah!
Oh my gosh, those kids liked me. They really liked me.
I really want to win a challenge. I have a lot of talent and I want to be able to show it by winning something.
I was shocked that people liked her. If Lisa gets an immunity, she's going to be here for only a week. And that just pisses me off.
I thought that Natalie was very charismatic. She was one of the best out of the group to me. She would be like Nichole.
I felt Natalie was the most well-rounded of all the performers today. She really did lead her group, and based on charisma, I felt that's something that she had mastered.
Wow!
Don't cry. Please, don't cry.
So girls, today you had to perform for your public. They're the ones that dictate the future of music and who's good and who's not, and I trust them. So the winner with the most votes is Natalie.
Yeah!
Robin said my name, I felt like I'd won Miss Universe. I was like, you know what I mean? I'm like, waving.
So congratulations, Natalie. You are safe from elimination for this week's performance.
Natalie's very pretty. Got some big boobs. I should have put my boobs out. I might have won.
Yeah. Good job, Natalie.
Even though I did not win the challenge, I still won. And I proved myself today. I really felt confident today. Like,
something just changed in me, and I learned that I can be me. I'm just gonna tell my life story, if that's okay with you guys. Maybe my story will inspire these girls up here to look at me in a different way. I've gone through a lot of my life, and I think that's why a lot of you may not really kind of feel me yet, and kind of might feel a little awkward towards me, or might be weird. Well, in August 2005, I was dancing, and I collapsed. I flatlined, and I was gone. I was dead for 30 minutes. So I went to the hospital, and I was in a coma. I ended up having a total of 3 surgeries. Then I got an implanted defibrillator, which is right here.
What's a defibrillator, though?
You know those things when you flatline, those big things that they go on your chest? That's, I have one in my heart, but it's about this big.
I understand her more. We shouldn't just respect her more because of her life story or whatever. We should have did it from the beginning.
It's a very, very, very rare heart disease because most people in the world that have it don't survive it.
I never did not like Ilisa. I mean, I always thought she was kind of a little awkward, but her story is just so inspiring.
I'm going to make it.
You know? Yeah, you got it, girl.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah, girl.
Got it. I'm here. And I have a very serious heart condition, but I'm dancing my heart out and I'm singing my heart out, and I made it to the top 11. I hope I inspired somebody.
You did. We love you, girl.
You inspired all of us.
In 5, 6, 7.
What you want, baby, I got.
I feel like Ilisa is a survivor. However, I don't feel like that's gonna make me change how I interact with her.
To be part of Girlicious, you can't be tomboylicious. It's Girlicious.
So we can move forward and backwards.
Uh-uh, don't change it.
I'm not changing it, sweetie. That's what they said. It's gonna be an inverted V when we get our stance.
They did?
Yes.
It is what it is. Girls are gonna act the way they want to, and there's a lot of fakeness and there's a lot of cattiness. At the end of this competition, who's gonna be there? Nobody. Nobody.
Tomorrow night, I'm gonna just do Ilisa. Just do me.
When you gonna live your life right?
I feel like the fact that I am applying to dental school and I am doing this, it helps me out and it hurts me, because some people think, oh, well, she has this other backup plan, so in her mind, she's like, whatever, if I get it, I get it, if I don't, I don't. But it's like, I work so hard. All I do is sing and dance, and if I have downtime, I'll study.
Do you want to, we need to rehearse. You want to rehearse, practice or dance?
Yeah, I mean, I do. I was just waiting.
I think Alexis is distracted, so I don't think her focus is mainly on this girl group. We don't have much time, so stop studying for a little bit.
Let's concentrate on the and pops.
Yeah, whip out my booty pops.
I do work my butt off stage, and I want to be able to apply that work ethic into my performance. And I would never let my group down, and I would never let myself down.
They just wanna, girls just wanna have fun.
Tiffanie's so crazy, like, we're all trying to meet at the middle, you know, and make things mesh well. And she needs to tone it down a little bit, because I don't want her to be the weak link in our group.
We gotta treat this like it's a musical. They do all that crazy ass dancing, and then they come out and they perform and they act.
I'm one of the faces,
oh, Lord. No acting for you, period. We get you.
With Tiffanie's personality, sometimes I feel like I have to reel Tiffanie back in.
And one of the faces,
excited, and I know our group's gonna do great, because this is a song where I get to show off my smile and have fun. I really feel like tonight's gonna be my night, so I'm very excited for this performance. It's my song, and I'm gonna rock out of it.
Whoa!
I'm not very nervous at all. I can't wait to go out there and kill it. I'm really confident, and I feel like I'm gonna do a really good job tonight.
Do you get really nervous?
I do. I get super nervous, but not for, like, performing, just for singing.
Whatever. We're gonna rock it tonight.
I'm your host, Mark McGrath, and welcome to the Pussycat Dolls Lounge on the Sunset Strip. As always, we are joined by our 3 judges. First up, she created the Pussycat Dolls. Say hello to my good friend, Robin Antin. Woo! Next up, he's a musician, a producer, and he now runs Geffen Records, Mr. Ron Fair. And finally, she's world-renowned as one of the top hip-hop artists ever, need I say more, the lovely Lil' Kim. All right, girls. Now, as always, the group with the weakest performance will be up for elimination. And, unfortunately, one of its members going home. Up first is group number one singing These Boots Are Made for Walking. Here are Tiffanie, Charlye, and Nichole. Yeah.
All over you.
There's definitely consistency issues, but on the other hand, really fun to watch.
Nichole, I don't know what it is. If it's a laziness thing, or it's because you're a kid, there wasn't a lot of precision to what you were doing. But from a raw talent standpoint, I mean, you have a lot of gifts that other people don't have.
Tiffanie, you got out there and you had authority and you embodied what the song was. You know, I really, really, really enjoyed watching you and listening to you.
She has star quality, but she also, I think, has a quality where she could fit in an ensemble and not upstage other people, but still shine, which is tricky.
Okay, well, Charlye, you were so confident. I really think that you have star quality.
Charlye, you made me remember you tonight.
Thank you.
All right, next up we have Carrie, Jamie, Cassandra, and Alexis, and a quote, Cyndi Lauper, girls just want to have fun. Good.
Thank you.
Jamie, I thought tonight was really surprising. You came out, you sang a tune, you had a great tone on it, and obviously with your strong dancing, it was it's pretty interesting.
Thank you.
Cassandra, I see that you've been working really hard vocally. You sounded really good.
Thank you.
Carrie, when you came out and sang your piece, you took the roof off the place. Clearly, that particular moment, you were fantastic.
Thank you.
You know, Alexis, this is absolutely your best performance ever.
Oh, thank you.
I just need a little bit more personality.
Alexis, individually, you've been inconsistent. One word that comes to my mind is like sorority girl.
It's the character in your voice. I'm wondering, do you really have that extra thing that makes somebody have a style?
Thank you, guys. And finally, group number three, performing Respect. So give a little respect to Chrystina, Ilisa, Natalie, and Jenna.
Iconic song, you know, it's a lot to live up to. Tackling Aretha Franklin, you made me think about you and not about Aretha Franklin singing that song, so good for you. Well, first of all, Natalie won the challenge yesterday. She is safe tonight. You won this challenge for a reason. Charisma, you are giving us charisma. Jenna, I really like your voice. I would enjoy listening to you on a record.
But the thing was the energy level of just standing there, knowing that we live in a world today where people listen to records with their eyes. Just having an incredible sound isn't enough.
Well, Ilisa, I mean, you can sing and you can dance, and that's really special, and I really think you have a huge career.
Out, you look like somebody very interesting, and you have a terrific voice.
All right, well, Chrystina, you let those nerves get the best of you every single time. Your voice even cracked at one point.
You have this fantastic persona on stage and a great look and everything, and I think you have the raw tools, but you need to practice.
I still need to see how much you want this show as who Chrystina really is.
All right, give a little respect to group number three, people. Come on.
I feel like everybody, when you guys do good, it feels good for me, you know what I mean?
I think it's going to be very tough for the judges to deliberate and come to a decision because everybody did so well.
Honestly, I think that the best group tonight was Girls Just Want to Have Fun. Hey,
so if somebody from our group goes on tonight, it's some bull. Yeah.
I thought my performance was good today, and I feel like my group did the best, and if the two best groups are safe, then absolutely I made it through. I'm in a state of shock right now. I think I did better than Chrystina tonight.
I feel like they know that I have it, but I don't feel like I'm like one of their favorites. I felt like I was gonna kill this performance, especially with my vocal, but then I was like, wow, my voice is out. Like, and that's like my most thing. That's my thing. So I just really have to keep my head up.
Tonight, personally, I felt that every group was equally as good.
I agree.
You feel they're equal.
Yeah. And normally there's going to be a group that's going to be up for elimination, which means one of the members would be going home. But I can go through these girls individually and pick apart what I liked and what I didn't like. So
shall we
do that? Okay. Just starting with Charlie.
she lights up a stage.
I agree. I think she's one of our better candidates right now.
Tiffanie, my God, that girl started in this competition. I really thought she was a joke. She's acting on stage and this whole theatrical thing that's like layered
very
on top
over
of her
the
voice.
Top.
She has a long way to go, but I am starting to really like her.
I think she has the shortest way to go of anybody here, just in terms of like natural chops. So what about Nichole?
I think that she's got something special.
Good set of pipes, decent dancer, moves good, looks good. On stage, sloppy.
Let's go to Carrie.
She was the most in-tune singer of the night.
Her and Jamie were my favorite.
I mean, Jamie has just grown. She's a dancer who can barely sing, and now she's actually got something kind of interesting.
Okay, so what about Alexis? Yeah.
Well, I definitely feel tonight she came out her shell more than other times, but the personality is just not grabbing me.
Yeah. Alexis, to me, is just one of those girls that, like, is cute, but just doesn't do anything that I'm like, wow.
I feel for her in the, from the ambition point of view and the desire, but it's like DNA. It's like Beyonce or not.
Yeah.
It's true.
I thought Cassandra was surprisingly good tonight.
I know.
The fearlessness was impressive. Okay, so what about Christina? Good set of pipes, decent dancer, undisciplined, needs time to practice.
She's got a really powerful voice, just needs to learn how to use it. If she let go of all the nerves, I just think she could be so amazing.
What about Natalie?
Natalie is so hot. Anyway, we can move on because she's safe tonight.
All right, so Jenna. She was very non-energetic and uncharismatic tonight. What about Ilisa?
Okay, the thing about Ilisa for me is she walks in the room and I look at her and I go, But as soon as she hits that stage, she's got everything that I want to see.
She's talented.
Yeah.
And she's really, a really talented girl. But again, Girlicious, I don't know.
I know.
Well, now we have to eliminate individually.
I think that we made the decision.
I think so, too.
All right, ladies, it's that time again. The judges have made their decision. Now, Natalie, you won this week's Charisma Challenge, so you cannot be eliminated. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Robin, take it away.
All right, girls. All three groups were exceptional tonight. Because all of the groups were equally as good, it comes down to individual performances. Charlie, Tiffanie, Carrie, Jamie, Cassandra, Ilisa. Congratulations. You girls have made it to the next round. Please step to the side. Jenna, you're a beautiful girl and I love your voice, but your performance, it just lacks energy. Chrystina, there's something inside of you. I believe that it's star quality, but the nerves get the best of you. My question to myself is, how many chances can I give you? Alexis, you are so cute and talented, but I'm still waiting for you to wow me. Nichole, you have a sound, you've got a vibe, you're sexy, you're hot, but on stage, your performance is sloppy. Congratulations. Jenna, you've made it to the next round. Please step to the side. Congratulations. Nichole, you've made it to the next round. Please step to the side. There are only two girls left. One will continue on, and the other will go home. The girl who will make it to the next round is Chrystina. Alexis, I'm sorry. You will not be in Girlicious. It's time to hang up your boa.
When I came into this competition, I knew I was gonna do well. I didn't necessarily think I would make the top 12. To be able to make it this far is such an honor.
My style is very different from this. So I was just myself, and I wasn't about to change who I was for this competition. It's harder for me to, like, say bye to those girls. The friendship, that's probably what I miss the most. It just boosted my confidence to know that I really do have talent. You know, I think, oh, dental school, like, I'm so smart, and, like, I'm gonna do that whole thing, but, you know, maybe I should rethink that, because I really am talented.